Chapter 9, Mishnah 7. This Mishnah cites other situations, some unrelated to Shemitah, where a deadline is marked by the second rains. Similarly, if one person rents a house to another and specifies that the lease should last until the rains, this means that the lease lasts until the second rains fall, and he may not evict the tenant before then. Likewise, if someone is prohibited by a neighbor to benefit from another person, and it is specified that the prohibition lasts until the rains, the prohibition remains in force until the second rains fall. During the harvest season, poor people are permitted to enter private fields to gather the gifts for the poor, i.e. the portions of the crop that the Torah obligates the owner to give to poor people. The Mishnah defines the point at which this permission no longer applies. Until when may the poor enter other people's orchards and fields to gather the gifts to the poor? Until the second rains fall. From the time that the second rains fall, seeds of the new crop begin to sprout, and walking on the land harms the newly growing plants. Stubble and straw that grew during Shemitah have Shemitah sanctity, because they could be fed to animals. One is thus forbidden to use them in a destructive manner, such as fuel for a fire. The Mishnah defines when this prohibition ceases to apply. From when may we benefit from or burn stubble and straw of Shemitah, from when the second rains fall in the eighth year. At that point, the straw and stubble in the fields become unfit for animals to eat, and so one must perform beer with the straw and stubble that he has in the house. Once beer has been performed with them, the straw and stubble lose their Shemitah sanctity and may be used even in a destructive manner.